Hello everyone, it's Marielle from SERPWizz, the number one lead generation tool for agencies looking to give white-labeled automated SEO reports. And today, we're going to show you guys how you can start using SEO ranking to conduct better SEO analysis. Specifically for today, we're going to show you guys how you can add backlinks for monitoring. So as you can see, we currently just are on the dashboard of our SEO ranking account, and what we're going to do first is select a project. So let's just first go over here to the left hand side, where you're going to see a drop down menu where you can select the project. We're going to choose our analysis for these tutorials that we've been doing. Okay, now that we're here, we're going to head over to the backlink monitor. So head over to the left side again, you'll see a list of projects. And under these projects, you'll see the different tools and features provided by SEO ranking to analyze these websites. One of them will read out backlink monitor right over here. All you gotta do is click that and wait for the page to open. Okay, so now that you're here, you can see that we have many options for adding backlinks. One of the options we're gonna go over is to add backlinks through either the backlink checker tool or manually or by connecting Google Search Console. So let's just try adding these manually by first hitting this green version, the green button that reads out add backlinks. So click this. And here, as you can see, you can either add backlinks by typing them down on a text box that SEO ranking will open for you, or you can also import it from a TXT or CSV file. So if you were to do the manual version, you just click this. You will see that the price manager and the backlinks list will appear right here. SEO ranking lets you specify the values of the price and the responsible manager when adding backlinks. So the values will be assigned to all backlinks entered manually or imported from the file. So once the necessary backlinks are added, let's say we've added a few links down here, all you gotta do is type them in, as you can see from this. We just typed in a random URL, we aren't really thinking about it. So once you've added all of them, the system will start collecting data on them. And once all the data is collected, the backlinks will appear in the list along with every other backlink. So in order to fully import this, you're going to have to finalize your backlink adder with the import button. And once you do, the backlink should be automatically added. Typically speaking though, because we didn't really add a real URL in this case or one that we're really interested in, that was just to show you guys how to add the backlink manually. Now, another way to add backlinks is to connect Google Search Console. So let's just first click this, you get a better idea of how this works. And from here, you'll see a notification saying that you should connect the site to the Google Search Console API through one of your Google accounts. You'll be asked to authorize SEO ranking to allow access to your Google account. In this case, we're going to do so with our corresponding account, and then we're going to let it in. Okay, so unless you're actually connected to your Google Search Console account, your Gmail will not necessarily work. In this case, we haven't added it, but we just went through those steps so you get an idea of how this would look like if you were to connect it through Google Search Console. Okay, so those are the two main methods that we used. If we were to go back, let's see if we can access the previous one really quick. Okay, so down here, it looks like there's even a backlink checker tool. Let's just check this out really quick to see if SEO ranking will allow us to use it. Odds are, though, you do need the full version, so let's just see if I can actually use this. Get the full list of backlinks of any domain along with additional data on each backlink. Okay, so here, if we were to add our link or domain right here, and make it as exact URL, you'll see that we have 1,688 backlinks we can choose from. But I'm going to see if we can actually access the full report. That's hopefully SEO ranking lets us use it, even though we're on a free account. Okay, so here now we're seeing the statistics in terms of how many referring domains, backlinks, and lost referring domains that we might have on our website. Let's see if we can get a list of them. Okay, so it looks like here are the backlink anchors and the distribution map. So this is really interesting. We're now given a list of the backlinks that are connected to our current website. And what we can actually do from here is choose one of these backlinks that we want to add to our backlink analysis. So that's just how the backlink searcher tool works. Hopefully this helps you better manage any sort of SEO analysis you might be doing. Thank you so much for watching our videos. Be sure to like and subscribe. And if you need any more help when it comes to SEMapper, be sure to check out the rest of our channel using either the link on the upper right corner of this video or any of the links below. See you next time!